Honorable Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, respected Chandrababu Naidu Garu, Honorable Sri Anant Kumar, Union Minister for Chemicals and Fertilizers, Government of India, respected Sri Ashok Gajapati Raju, respected Sri Chaudhary Garu, Sri Puneet Mazumdar, Sri Subhash Chandra, Mr. Lee, Mrs. Suresh Raidu, delegates, gracious ladies and gentlemen. I am indeed delighted to be part of this summit, the 22nd CII Partnership Summit, and I do not know why it is called the Sunrise AP Investment Meet. This is something which beats me because you have a chief minister who probably does not know what sunrise is or what sunset is. So for a man who does not know the difference between sunset and sunrise, I do not know why you call this a sunrise summit. But this is the type of chief minister we have had to suffer in the state, and you have also seen it over the last 3 days, how difficult a taskmaster he is. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'm indeed happy to be at this valedictory function because rarely do we see a valedictory function which still has so many delegates present, because normally the valedictory function being one of the last in its time, many people vanish. This itself shows your hunger for investment in Andhra Pradesh, leaving behind your hunger for lunch, which is due very shortly. So I shall not keep your hunger prolonged though your hunger for investment is very much visible to us. Well, all concepts in the world have undergone a change over the years. In the past, a nation's strength was determined by its military might, its ability to withstand aggression, its ability to guard its territories. So the whole thing was, the nation's strength was judged by its military capabilities. And also, ideology dictated the norm of the world. But today, the situation has undergone a whole change, where ideology has given way to technology. And today, a nation's strength is guided not just by the military might, but by various other components like energy security, food security, health security, environmental security, technological security, so superiority, and also a normal security, which is sensitive to inclusivity as its base mark. So this being the development, and that is where I think your role comes in a very big way. India's growth story will be driven by reforms at the Government of India level, as well as initiative taken by the states. At this juncture, it is pertinent to highlight that progressive states will be the key fulcrum that will drive India's growth. In fact, in the federal structure of things that we have, to have today what we have in India is a new experiment in cooperative federalism, where the states are equal partners with the center. The center and the states act as in unison in moving their development mode, because we are looking at the growth of India and not of growth of any individual state. Unless all limbs of the body are strong, the body will not be strong. And that is the effort of Mr. Narendra Modi, our Prime Minister. Andhra Pradesh has kept the above changing paradigm while formulating its vision, with happiness quotient as the base fundamental remark. We are not looking at GDP growth, because GDP growth is probably many times it's a statistical formulation where it might differ, you might differ from your way you are calculating the GDP, and I may differ from the way I calculate my GDP. But we are looking at happiness quotient. The people's happiness quotient will be our benchmark for progress and development as far as Andhra Pradesh is concerned. And this is where I think investments become very important, because we're looking at inclusive growth. And unless investments come, it is going to sort of broadcast our employment opportunities. Because social welfare schemes is good up to a point. But beyond a point, unless people are employed, the economy will not grow. And the economy has to move, people have to be employed. And employment means new avenues. And as the health minister himself has, our union minister has pointed out, we are coming out a number of schemes for that. Viewed against this background, this partnership summit is indeed is extremely useful. I understand a number of MOUs have been inked during the last few days. I have a small suggestion for your consideration, ladies and gentlemen. I think rather than calling them MOUs, I think we need to call them IOUs in future. Because you owe us something, we owe you something. So I think instead of calling it an MOU, which is just a question of an understanding, I think it's a question of IOU. I think an IOU has a greater responsibility on the shoulders of both of you, both of us. Well, as far as the government of Andhra Pradesh on its front is concerned, we assure you that we will give you a hassle-free single window clearance, a good infrastructure, a chain of seaports, a visionary leadership, and a look-ahead policy. This is what Andhra Pradesh, amongst the many other things that it will provide to you. And on your side, we expect investments in various sectors. Investments not just for the mere investments, but but in certain very critical sectors, particularly sectors like pharmaceuticals, because as I told you, health security, food security, environmental security, these become very important in the nation's development and its happiness quotient. I think today, I think in terms of health security, I think the minister's statement that he is going to have NIPERS, which is going to come up, which will, and also medical devices, things to manufacture medical devices. Today, I think health security is one of the most important things for the common man. And the common man's happiness index is dictated by the cost of medication. How well is or how good is our healthcare program? And if our healthcare program is to be made affordable to the common man, I think if we're able to manufacture medical devices in India, the Make in India program, I'm sure the medical cost will come down considerably. Also in the field of pharmaceuticals, I think the research and development. Because I think we need to sort of really look at how we can devise newer medication to sort of fight various diseases which are coming up. I mean, every day we come up with an ailment which has a new name and we don't even understand what that name is all about. So I think research and development in the field of pharmaceuticals is extremely important, and I'm thankful to the minister that he's agreed to look into both these aspects. And so also agriculture. Today I think food security becomes very important because with a growing number of mouths to feed, with a diminishing land, and with an erratic monsoon, I think we need to see how we can devise newer technologies to promote agriculture. How can we increase the food available in a limited land, in lesser land and more food, and an erratic monsoon at that? This is going to be one of the biggest challenges to technologies all over the world. The third thing that I'm looking at is energy security. While we have a lot of energy, I think we need to look at other alternate forms of energy, because thermal energy or hydro energy is not going to last us forever. So I think we need to look at alternate sources of energy, probably the wind energy and the solar energy, which we are planning to tap in a very big way. And I would invite you people to invest in these two particular fronts, because these are energies which will last us forever. Because the sun is going to be there forever and the wind is going to be there forever, but neither thermal nor hydro energy forever. We are also in a very big way. I mean, you have to imagine what recently happened in Chennai, the El Nino effect that is being predicted all over the time. We look at drought proofing, and we require also disaster management. Drought proofing and disaster management technologies, I think, need a lot of importance. And that is one area where I request you people to sort of see how we can use technology for drought proofing and also for the, for example, recently I was in Anantapur with the chief minister when we inaugurated a drought proofing program. It was an extremely good program because ultimately we had to reach it to the farmers. We cannot keep drought proofing only at the metropolitan level. It has to go down to the farmers because that is where agriculture is going to suffer, and we need to keep agriculture going. Then, of course, we are looking at the smart cities. What is a smart city that we are talking about? Various definitions are given for smart cities. But ultimately, smart city is how happy are the people going to be there? What is it that they're going to get out of the smart city? You may have various, you can look at the IT industry, you can look at other, but basics, transportation, communication, infrastructure, health, food, education, these are the major things that are available. Connectivity. And today, Andhra Pradesh is looking at sort of providing you connectivity right up to the house level, at every village level. That is what is our dream. So that sort of connectivity, communications, and infrastructure. If you're going to have express highways, speeding highways, distances are going to be cut. And today in an era where we are living as a global village, whatever happens in one part of the world is going to impinge on other parts of the world. And I'm sure the development that will hit Andhra Pradesh will soon impact on the rest of the country and the rest of the world, the rest of the world by itself. In fact, as Chandrababu Naidu I was about to say, this looked almost like a Davos meeting. We don't require even other segments of society, because Davos is this sort of a friendly meeting where people sit down and discuss, and that is what I think, it's a very good suggestion that we should convert Vizag into a Davos. I think we need to rename it. We will not call it Davos, but I think we'll give it a Telugu name and not Davos. I hope so, sir. Let us not repeat Davos, but let's have a Telugu name for that. I'm sure with your ability, you'll be able to pick it up. And with this, I wish this conference all success. And as I told you, we have already been to the base camp. All of you have arrived at the base camp. Now you and I will have to partner to reach the summit and hoist the flag of development. That is our responsibility. That is what I or we, the government of Andhra Pradesh, owe to you, and you as investors owe to us. May God bless you all, and thank you very much.